Duffy's bodyguard, Eugene Deal, exactly what had happened in Las Vegas. In his police interview, he got all the details right.
It was just Daddy and some other people I know from New York. They were in Vegas the night Pac got killed. You know what I'm saying? They're around the same crib that rolled with us to Vegas that time.
Mm-hmm.
And Pac seen them. Mm-hmm. And Pac stepped to them and said, those are those mark-ass niggas that be fucking with some niggas from New York. That's what was said.
Now, were you there for this?
No, I wasn't there for
this. You were told this.
I was told, I thought that was pretty quickly history. And one of the kids had ripped off Pop, one of Pop's friends, you know, a long time ago or something like that. You know, I said it was a fight group broke out. You know what I'm saying? And that's how that incident happened.
Mm-hmm.
And one of the kids called his uncle who was ahead.
Mm-hmm.
One of the head guys was cops and stuff like that. And then next thing you know, Pop was shot up.
We also found an informant who was a Southside Crip, an associate of all these guys, who confirmed PPD's story.
Who was in Las Vegas that you know on that deal on that night that Tupac got killed?
Okay, Milo, Keith Brown, Dre.
More importantly, this informant claimed that he had personally seen Orlando Anderson and DeAndre Smith in a white Cadillac in Compton the day after Tupac was shot, and that DeAndre, not Orlando, had bragged about shooting Tupac.
Dre and Orlando, they came back bragging about what happened out there. He seen Tupac and Big Sug, I think, in a BMW, and he said he let off on him.
Man, I let off on Tupac.
Dre said he himself let off on him. What does let off on him mean?
He's shooting a person. Right. Like it was a big old joke or something. It was a big joke. You can tell when a person nervous. They were nervous when they got back talking. You know, you can tell they had nerves. You know?
The informant also confirmed what Keefe D had said about the Cadillac being a rental car.
Yeah, it was a rental car, yeah.
You know, how do you know that that Cadillac was a rental car?
Because every time they go to Vegas, they get a rental car. They get a rental car because if you're going out of town and the police ever find something in there, it's a rental car. They can't really put it on there. If you see Keith right now, he's in a rental car right now.
Who besides yourself down there knows for one knows about these guys killing Tupac?
Shit, pretty sure everybody around.
We now had evidence that pointed to Orlando Anderson as the killer of Tupac Shakur. With the benefit of hindsight, it now seemed obvious. If, prior to our interviews with Keefe D in late 2008, I'd been asked to put together a list of the most likely suspects, he'd have been at the top of the list. Knowing that didn't make us great detectives, it was just common sense.
I had a person I was talking to who told me that she was related to Orlando Anderson, and she told me that at family gathering, Orlando Anderson would brag about killing Tupac.
Orlando was so committed to boasting about the shooting of Tupac that even his uncle, Keefe D, had to scold him and tell him to keep his mouth shut and quit talking about it. But instead, Orlando Anderson goes on CNN with his attorney.
I mean, I've been thinking, you know, maybe I'm like scapegoat, so I just want to let everybody know. You know what I'm saying? I didn't do it.
Immediately after the murder of Tupac Shakur, Compton police knew that Orlando Anderson was involved. They knew this because of their confidential informants, Southside Crip informants, who were telling them so. In fact, they conducted search warrants and even arrested Orlando Anderson. Unfortunately, though, for Las Vegas police, there wasn't enough evidence for prosecution. Orlando Anderson lawyered up, and everything else was just circumstantial, not enough to get a criminal filing.
There was one more piece of evidence tying Orlando Anderson to this case that shocked the task force when they discovered it. Going back to the murder of Shook's friend and bodyguard, Jake Robles, at the nightclub in Atlanta, the incident that took the feud between Death Row and Bad Boy to the next level. They found an interview that Russell Poole had conducted with a nightclub security guard who was an off-duty Atlanta police officer named Deputy Howard. In this interview from 1997, they showed Howard the MGM Grand security video of Orlando Anderson and a photo of Keefe's friend, Corey Edwards. Deputy Howard was absolutely positive that both Orlando Anderson and Corey Edwards were at the club, and that they were among the suspects in the Robles shooting.
Deputy Howard also stated that the altercation that took place inside of the club was between Robles and Suge and a guy in a powder blue jacket. At one point, Suge told the guy in the blue jacket, "I know your family. I know your mama. I know your family." He also told Robles after he was shot, "Hush, I'll take care of this when we get back on our own turf." Now, why would Suge Knight say, "I know your family," or that we can take care of this when we get back to Los Angeles, to a person that was a member of Bad Boy from New York City? Making the connection for us, Deputy Howard confirmed that the person that was in the powder blue jacket was none other than Orlando Anderson.
Within a month of returning from Las Vegas after the Tupac murder, Suge Knight is arrested for a parole violation for his participation in the stomp down of Orlando Anderson.
Desperate to get himself out of his predicament, Suge Knight then offers Orlando Anderson upwards of $16,000 to testify on his behalf that he wasn't actually attempting to assault Orlando, but was trying to help him. So Orlando Anderson, who has just shot and killed Tupac Shakur and struck Suge Knight in that hail of gunfire, is now being summoned and solicited by Knight himself to perjure himself on Knight's behalf in court.